Hello, in this video, we'll be covering the k-nearest neighbors algorithm. The k-nearest neighbors algorithm is a supervised learning method used for classification and regression. For classification, the output of the k-nearest neighbors algorithm is the classification of an unknown data point based on the k-nearest neighbors in the training data. For regression, the output is an average of the values of a target variable based on the k-nearest neighbors in the training data. In a classification problem, the k-nearest neighbors algorithm works as follows. Pick a value for k. Search for the k observations in the training data that are nearest to the measurements of the unknown data. Predict the response of the unknown data point using the most popular response value from the k-nearest neighbor. What happens if we choose a very low value of k? Let's say k equals 1. If we're trying to classify our data points into two categories, red and blue for instance, then we may get a diagram that looks like this. The black dotted line represents the curve that separates the red and blue classification regions. We want to choose a k that will create a separation of the regions that best matches this line. As you can see, there are very jagged edges following the data points. Now, if we have an out-of-sample data point, let's say here, the first nearest point, since k equals 1, would be blue, as that's the point that it's on. This would be a bad prediction, since more of the points around it are red. Therefore, the point should be considered red. But since it is blue, we can say that we've captured the noise in the data, or we've chosen one of the points that represented an anomaly in the data. Another way to visualize this would be something like the diagram on the right. It looks very similar to the one on the left, but please note how the division line between these two categories would look. Pause the video now and think about it for a bit. Okay, so keeping that in mind, it could look something like this. A low value of k causes a highly complex model, which causes an overfitting of the dataset. Overfitting is bad, as we want a general model that works for any data, not just the trained data. Now, on the opposite side of the spectrum, if we choose a very high value of k, such as k equals 100, then the model becomes overly generalized. This makes it difficult to distinguish between the two regions if a point appears between the two regions. The white region is a spot where neither blue nor red can be decided. So let's say we have an out-of-sample data point here. Can you tell which region that belongs on? Probably not. And if we look at the black dotted line that we want to follow, we can see that the model doesn't follow this at all. And finally, this is what a decent value of k might look like. Here we've used k equals 16, and we can see a divide in the data that mimics the black dotted line, producing a fairly accurate model for this data set. Also, looking at the regions, there are no areas of noise like we saw in the diagram with a low k. The lighter shades in each region simply mean that the model is less certain about the predictions of what to classify a data point in that area. Bringing back the model that we had from before, how do you think the line would look like in this case? There's a good chance that it might look something like this. This line is a lot more general than the one we saw from before. Another key point to consider is that there are some difficulties when dealing with out-of-sample data. Out-of-sample data means data that's outside of the dataset used to train the model. Since we're dealing with out-of-sample data in the real world, it's hard to determine whether predictions using out-of-sample data will produce an accurate result. This is because we don't know what the result of the out-of-sample data should be, thus making it hard to determine the accuracy. Later on, we'll discuss how to evaluate a model's ability to classify out-of-sample data. A good example of where machine learning can be applied is email. Think about all the emails that you receive every day. Do you get 10, 20, 100, maybe even 1,000 a day? How much of that is ham or spam? Your email likely uses machine learning to help categorize this based on specific words that may indicate that the email is spam, and helps use that information to categorize and relate emails that are similar. K k-nearest neighbors regression problems are concerned with predicting the outcome of a dependent variable given a set of independent variables. To begin, let's consider the diagram shown above, where a set of points are drawn from the relationship between the dependent variable y and the independent variable x. Given the set of training data, the unshaded circles which lie on the curve, we use the k-nearest neighbors algorithm to predict the outcome y for x equals 5.6, also known as query point given the training data. First, let's consider the one nearest neighbor method as an example. In this case, we search the training set and locate the one closest to the query point x. For this particular case, this happens to be x6. The outcome of x6, that is, y6, is then taken to be the answer for the outcome of x, which is denoted as y. Thus, for one nearest neighbor, we can write y equals y6. This point, xy, is represented by the red circle on the diagram. Now let's consider two nearest neighbors method. In this case, we locate the first two closest points to x, which happens to be x5 and x6. Taking the average of their outcomes, y5 and y6, the solution for y is then given by y equals y5 plus y6 divided by 2. This point, xy, is represented by the green circle on the diagram. Alternatively, we can also approach regression problems using the weighted k-nearest neighbors algorithm. This algorithm works by assigning weights to the k-nearest neighbors depending on the distance of the points to the query point. The closer the neighboring point is to the query point, the larger the assigned weight will be. Keep in mind, however, that the sum of the weights must be equal to 1. Thanks for watching.